St. Louis. Hosea 4 and 6 declares, My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. You have just tuned into a different kind of ministry. A ministry that will teach you how to know your purpose, how to know your gifts and talents, how to be an overcomer, how to receive knowledge, get wisdom, and apply your understanding in the area of business. A ministry that will teach you how to apply biblical principles to your daily life. Praise Him Productions presents the How To Broadcast with Patricia Borsch Claire.
Welcome to the How To Show. And what you were saying, we have Lady Gina Pearson on the How To Show. How you doing, great woman of God?
Their truth. Living their truth.
Yeah.
Walking in their purpose.
Yes. Yes. You are so awesome. I tell you, we are so glad that we're talking to Lady Gina Pearson. And last week, she got a chance to call in on the How To Show, which we did a part one series, which we will be doing part two on how to know the role of a pastor's wife. And how are you doing, great woman of God?
I am doing great, Patricia. It's great to be with you again today.
Oh, we're going to have to hook up and do some things. Amen.
Amen. It'll be great when we can do that in person.
Yes. And you know something? We're going to be right back with Lady Gina Pearson on the How To Show. Stay tuned for more. Show. Welcome to the How To Show. I'm your host, Patricia Porch Claire. How are you feeling on today? Well, I hope you're feeling blessed because you know that I am. And you know, God is just moving in a mighty way in these last days. And we're so excited that He has chosen us who are the living to be able to close out Revelation. Yes, He did. You know something? Again, we're speaking to Lady Gina Pearson, who is the wife, the lovely, beautiful, anointed wife of Bishop Carlton Pearson in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And we want to say hello to the great man of God, which God is charging him, my goodness, to do some great things in these last days. And again, Lady Gina Pearson, welcome to the How To Show.
Thank you, Patricia.
Oh, it's so great to have you on the show. And you know something, again, we're just doing part two from last week where we picked off at, and we know that you have shared your testimonies and your praise reports of your completing your goal at the age of 40. You were able to complete a marathon, and you got a chance to Ralph the Grand Canyon. Is that so?
That was so. That was an exciting experience.
You speak
of great growth.
You speaking up with the water and all?
And living out. I lived out in the canyon for that entire week, camping and bearing the elements. I mean, it allowed me an opportunity to see who I was outside of the St. John.
Wow. I think that would be an awesome retreat for women.
Well, you know, when you can get down to the bare elements, it's unfortunate that we don't feel safe to live that day to day. But when we can be transparent with one another and become a part of a team greater than ourselves,
yes,
that's when you really can see things happen in each other's lives.
Oh, my goodness. I mean, I just thank God that you're on the show along with the other pastor wives that we have, because everybody has a puzzle piece that they can put into this big complete puzzle that we're trying to complete on the role of a pastor's wife. And when God had me to look up the term role are really different assignments, things that you do. That's not who you are, but
exactly.
The role is the assignments. Most people may say, well, you wear many hats. You're not the many hats. You do of the many hats. Those are just the assignments in your activities that God have you to do. But as a person, you got a chance to describe to us the things that you do for self and to be a blessing as well for your husband and his calling. And we're speaking on how to know the role of a pastor's wife. You know something, Lady Gina Pearson, we would like to know why is there a conflict between meeting precede expectations and simply being yourself?
Well, because we don't know who we are as individuals. Yes. And then that we do know, we don't trust that it would be accepted by other people. Mm-hmm. So we put ourselves under the stress and the scrutiny of trying to meet the expectations of those outside of us who don't know who we are. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's an insane way of being. Mm-hmm. If we can tap into the gift that we are and allow ourselves to unwrap that, regardless of what that may be, if we could learn to live in our honesty, Patricia, it would relieve us of a lot of the pressures and stress of what the world thinks we need to be.
My goodness, that is awesome. You know, why are most pastors' wives reserved like a silence, a quietness about expressing their true feelings?
Well, again, you know, and I don't think it's just pastors' wives. I think it's many of us in the church.
That's true.
We don't feel safe in speaking our truth. You know, we feel there may be condemnation upon us. And I think it's one of the greatest things we can do is be honest, live in that place of owning what's true for us, regardless of what it looks like.
My goodness. And what are your feelings about, like, your husband sharing the household duties? We're switching over here.
Well, you know, I have strong feelings about that. He's downstairs right now cooking brunch for the kids. It's one of the favorite things he does on Saturday morning, which relieves me to be able to do other things that I want to do on Saturday morning, maybe work out or something. But he's very involved, sometimes more than others. But Saturday morning is his time to cook breakfast for the kids. My husband's a great cook.
Wow.
You know, and he does other things around here that I'm so grateful for when he does contribute.
You know something, we should have called up a lot of bishops and archbishops so they can get that part. But I'm going to have to send them this CD so they can get that part.
Well, it's not a usual thing, and it's not an everyday thing for him. But when he does help me, it is, I really appreciate it.
Exactly. And that's what it's all about, two working as one.
That's right.
My goodness.
That's right.
My goodness. Again, we're speaking to Lady Gina Parrison, and we're going to be right back, and we're going to be speaking on the different contingent spirits. How does a pastor wife, first lady, deal with a contention spirit? And contention spirit is envy, strife, division, jealousy, carnality, disputers, and women who specifically comes to distract the man of God in the ministry. We'll be right back on the How To Show with Lady Gina Parrison.
Our God is an awesome God, and He reigns from heaven above. He's the power of God, our God. Everybody say,
singing in Russian. My goodness, it's awesome. We're back with Lady Gina Parrison, and we're speaking on the subject, how to know the role of a pastor's wife. She has really blessed our soul. And as we're coming to the close on our closing statement, and that is, I ask Lady Gina Parrison, because she has so much wisdom in this field, how do pastor wives deal with women who have a contingent spirit. That's against you. We know that there's a lot of women that's against the pastor's wife that's in the church, and nobody is not really talking on it. So God passed the ball to me to talk on it. And it's dealing with the envy, the strife, division, jealousy, carnality, disputers, and women who specifically come to distract the man of God in ministry. Amen.
Well, Patricia, that's a very real scenario of what lives out there.
Yes.
And, you know, my role is to continue to walk in love.
Yes.
I have been confronted head on with this over and over and over again.
Mm.
And I have a young woman in my life now who literally says she's in love with my husband. And she knew him. She's traveled around the country and followed my husband for years. But really, to help her come into her own reality mm-hmm. is what I feel my role is, to help her live her truth. Obviously, it's a spirit of deception because mm-hmm. he can't be married to two women.
Yes.
And he didn't choose her. He chose me. So I don't have a war with these women. My role is to walk in love
yes.
and be a receptacle of truth that they may come into the knowledge of the fullness of what their purpose is in life.
My goodness, that is incredible. And so at the same time, what you're stating is that God allowed, not that he done it, but he allowed things to happen so they can also be ministered to.
Well, that's the key thing. You know, why do I need to be mad with this woman?
Yes.
You know,
yes.
She sent him notes and she's, you know, made efforts to communicate, and we've addressed her together.
Yes.
And so I've begun to embrace her, to help her walk out
wow.
her reality, you know, yes. and to see that, you know, you're deceived and without saying that to her.
Oh, I see. That is awesome. Or are you holding a seminar on disciplinary and or related to or mentorship?
Well, I work with a group of women here every year called Esther's Company.
Okay.
And these are women that I handpick to pour into their lives. And, you know, we do different things. Like one of the exercises we do is the road course
mm-hmm.
where we stretch ourselves to discover the depth of who we are. So mm-hmm. yes, I do that on a regular basis with women here locally.
Well, I truly believe it's going to be nationally, and he's just preparing you as you're blessing us. And we thank you so much. We're talking with Lady Gina Pearson. We thank you so much for blessing our souls. And that, Lady Gina Pearson, you have really blessed our hearts and how to deal with our Hamans in our lives and to minister to your Hamans so God can touch their hearts and turn them over into the Christ-like they're supposed to be. Amen?
Amen, Patricia. It's a desire to always be with you.
Oh, we love you so much. The How-To listeners, we love you from being on the show. And we know that you're going to someday get a chance to be on the How-To show when we go on satellite.
Yes.
Well, take care. God bless and hold on the line. And listeners, we'll see you next week on the How To Show.
With your host, Patricia Forge Claire, this program has been brought to you by Praise Him Productions.